Malaysia is a diverse, friendly, and thriving country, and it has a wide array of diversity and deliciousness in its food as well.
So we start in Kuala Lumpur, nicknamed KL, and you may be surprised to learn that it's much more modern than you think.
The architecture of this modern city is breathtaking. There is more on KL in our other shows and segments.
Now, KLCC, for example, also known as the Twin Towers, shows off a spectacular 80 stories and features a connecting bridge about midway. It's surrounded by a beautiful park and places to hang out.
The shopping mall here is large and abundant with a plethora of incredible high-end shops. At the top is a fabulous hotspot called Marini's 57.
Now, this is a country where many Americans could live, but for the rest of the segment, we're going to go local and historical.
And visit some of the extraordinary sights and foods that the surrounding areas have to offer and that you won't find anywhere else in the world.
So get ready for some local Malaysian-style hospitality plus some incredible food finds and places you won't want to miss.
First off, a must for you to try is bak kut teh. This is a local dish that is unique and delicious.
Different neighborhoods feature different styles of bak kut teh, and we'll take you to two of the best.
First, we are here in Cheras, a local neighborhood at Soon Huat Bak Kut Teh. This is a Jetsetter hidden gem. The kitchens are small, but they get the job done along with the hardworking staff.
Bak kut teh loosely translates to meat bone tea. It is traditionally eaten for breakfast, but is quite commonly enjoyed for lunch now as well.
Pork ribs are simmered in a multifaceted broth that includes black garlic, herbs and spices like fennel, cloves, and cinnamon.
Another beauty of bak kut teh is how customizable it is for each person. You can add as much or as little fresh garlic and chilies into your bak kut teh as you desire.
Fresh veggies like mushrooms and additional Chinese herbs can be included as well. And you also can add lettuce and bean curd if you like.
Now, this is the wet version, and there is a dry version as well. The wet version retains a classic broth, making it more like a soup.
We'll take you to the dry version at our next restaurant, another hidden gem, and that is in Klang. It's about a 45-minute car ride from Kuala Lumpur.
Klang is known for some of the best bak kut teh in Malaysia and is believed to be the birthplace where it originated.
This is restaurant Wang Hyong. Here we had a special dry version of bak kut teh, only available in Klang.
Locals crowd in here every day to enjoy the bak kut teh with family and friends.
In the dry version, the broth is reduced to more of a thick gravy, making it more like a stew. Then they add in other ingredients that can include chilies, dried dates, and squid.
The pork in the dry version is very tender and juicy, and it has a tangier and stronger flavor than the wet version.
You can get the wet bak kut teh here as well. And along with the bak kut teh, we also got a variety of platters of fresh mussels, noodles, chicken, fried rice, and fresh fish.
Now, these noodles were super yummy and filled with fresh herbs and flavor. And these flat Cantonese fried noodles are to die for.
Now, here is a Jetsetter inside secret. Check out this unique way to sanitize and cleanse your silverware and chinaware.
So make sure you try both wet and dry bak kut teh at least once. And if you can get to Klang, that's a hidden gem where you can enjoy the birthplace of bak kut teh.
And here is your next must-try, satay. These sweet and smoky bites of deliciousness are a popular cuisine made with marinated chicken, beef, or other forms of meat, skewered, and then barbecued.
Satay is believed to have been introduced by Javanese immigrants and sold by street vendors.
We are here at Restaurant Satay KL on Gurney Road, another hidden gem from our Jetsetter local, Ryan.
Okay, this is the Malaysian delicacy called satay. So it's like skewers. This is chicken, and we've got beef here, a little cut down below there, a little darker. And it's eaten, served with ketupat. This is like rice cooked in a special form. And we have cucumber and onion. It goes along with it. And the best of all, we have the satay sauce. It's made out of some spices and peanut. It goes really well. And if you like spicy, you add a little bit of chili. Enjoy!
Now, this is the perfect street food, but you can sit down here and enjoy the local ambiance. Trust us, this place will satisfy all of your satay cravings and then some.
Now, get ready to work off all of this food that we've been eating.
That's right. The climb may be tough, 272 steps to be exact, but it is a good workout and the views are spectacular.
The Batu Caves are almost 100 meters high, and the temple area is made up of three main caves and some smaller ones.
Along the way, you'll see some unique and beautiful sights. This is the Murugan statue. He is also the Hindu god of war.
It's 140 feet tall and took 3 years to build. You'll also make some little friends along the way.
That's right. Get ready to talk to the animals, specifically the monkeys.
Do you have a license for your minky?
That is not my minky.
Well, Inspector Clouseau, there are no licenses here. The monkeys run wild and free.
Bags of nuts are sold so you can hand them out on your way up.
Inside the first caves, you'll find ornate Hindu shrines, statues, and temple monuments.
This statue of Hanuman is an entrance to the Ramayana cave. Hanuman is one of the central characters in the Indian epic Ramayana, and the walls of the cave depict the story of Rama.
The Batu Caves hold festivals and pilgrimages, too.
Come here and pray, and, you know, for Tomu Nusim, they carry, heavy vehicles, right, up, so that, they feel that all their past sins are cleansed, and they start anew.
The light shines through the caves in many beautiful ways at different times of the day. And believe it or not, there are rock climbing routes available in certain areas, too.
More in-depth audio tours are available, and it is definitely worth the trip to see the wondrous natural beauty of the Batu Caves.
Plus, to make some new little monkey friends, too.
And when we come back, we will take you to another popular food in Malaysia, Indian curry.